So, hello students, let us continue our discussion on communication system. Let's start a new topic, introduction to analog transmission. Suppose we have a signal that can be voice signal or a speech signal, or pictures, videos, and we are interested to transfer this signal from one point to another, because this signal contains some information. And we are interested in transferring this information from one point to another point or multiple number of points. So at the sender's end, there will be a transmitter . What the transmitter will do, it will match the characteristics of this signal with the channel characteristics so that the message can be transferred from the sender's end. Now the channel can be wired or wireless. The message can be sent over a cable or in space, radiated by an antenna. Let's suppose if there is an antenna at the sender's end, and there is another antenna at the receiver's end. Now at the receiver's end, just like the transmitter, there will be a receiver. That will do an exact opposite function as in case of transmitter, so that finally we will receive the same information that can be voice, picture, video, anything, the information of our interest, or we can call it as the message signal. And this is how an analog transmission system. Now, during the course of transmission through the channel, signal gets noisy. Since a physical channel is not an ideal channel, that means the signal is bound to have distortions, or during the course of time, during the transmission of the message signal, some unwanted signals called noise gets added to the message signal or the information signal. So at the receiver end, the receiver has to perform one more function of denoising the message signal. We will see how it is done. And finally, we obtain an undistorted message signal at the output, or we get the desired message signal at the output. Now, broadly classified, there are two types of analog signal transmission. One is baseband transmission and another one is passband transmission. So let's have a brief discussion on both of these types of transmission. First one is baseband transmission. Signals such as voice signals or video images data So such type of signals that contain information after passing through a transducer we convert them to electrical form as electrical signals. Then these signals are known as baseband signals. The reason that they are called baseband signals is that they fall at the lower frequency range. For example, the voice signal or the speech signal or the human voice has a frequency range from around 100 to 300 hertz to 3 kilohertz. Similarly, video signals have a frequency range around less than 4.5 megahertz. So these signals fall into a lower frequency range. That is why they are called baseband signals. Or they are also low pass signals. Since these signals contains message and information, then we will call them as message signals. Let's say M of T. Let's say its Fourier transform is represented as M of F. With the help of Fourier transform, we can represent any signal in the frequency domain, because a message signal can be a mixture of many signals of different frequencies. So when we represent such signal on the frequency plot, then such a representation is called frequency spectrum. Now we can represent a message signal or a low pass signal starting from 0 to a cutoff frequency fm. Where fm is? cut off frequency of the signal. Let's say in hertz. What does this frequency spectrum represents? That the message signal contains those frequencies that fall between the range 0 to FM. And you can see this is of a low pass nature. And such signals are called baseband signals. Let us take an example of a telephone signal or telephonic transformation. There will be a physical speech signal that is cached by a microphone. It is amplified with the help of amplifier and transferred directly over the channel. And then at the receiving end, this is the sender's end. This is the receiving end, and once again amplified and received at the output. Now it can be a telephone. So you see here, this baseband signal is being transferred directly from sender's end to the receiver's end. Since the transfer of the baseband signal is direct, since the transfer of signals is direct without any, let's introduce a term here, modulation. Since the transfer is direct, then this is without modulation. Then such type of transmission is baseband transmission. The telephonic signal transmission that we used in earlier days, that is an example of a baseband signal transmission. Now there are various limitations of baseband transmission. Let's see them. limitations of baseband transmission. First is baseband signal. Cannot be transferred baseband transmission cannot occur over very large distances. Only few kilometers. The reason is, if we do the direct transmission, then the baseband signals attenuate heavily. Let's say if we take the example of a speech signal. Now, speech signals are basically pressure signals, as we know. So, suppose this is the source of the speech signal. Suppose there is a certain pressure level P1 at the intensity of sound is, let's say P1 at point at spherical distance at a radius of R1 from the source. Then let's say we take another point R2 . So if R2 is around 2 times of R1, then the pressure, the sound intensity, the intensity of sound at point at radius P2 from the source falls by around 6 decibels. Hence, baseband transmission cannot be occur for large distances because the signal attenuates very heavily. This is one limitation of baseband transmission. Second, we can see baseband transmission cannot occur over radio. Suppose we want to transmit the baseband signals directly by an antenna. Now, according to the concept of antenna transmission, the length of antenna required is is given as integral multiple of the quarter wavelength of the wave. Since the baseband signals are low frequency signals, then they will have a very high wavelength. So, which will be given as an inverse relation with the frequency, where c is the speed of light. Suppose we take a low pass signal which has a frequency of, let's say, 3 kHz. So in that case, if we find the length of antenna, which will be given as 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second upon 4 into 3 into 10 power 3 hertz. So in this case, the length of antenna that we will get will be around, so this will be 10 to the 5 by 4, which will be around 25 kilometers. So you can see this is a very huge value, which is not feasible. We cannot design a very large antenna for direct transmission of baseband signals. So this is another limitation. Let's see third limitation with respect to baseband transmission is mixing of signals. Suppose there are so many TV stations are there. So this is TV station 1, 2, or some. There are, suppose, n TV stations are there. And suppose our television is connected by a channel or cable, you can say. Now, for the purpose of transmission of the signal, the signal characteristic must match with that of channel characteristics. So one of the characteristics of signal or the channel is the bandwidth. Bandwidth is nothing but the frequency range. The range of frequency on which the set of signals fall. Suppose our signal or the message signal contains frequency that falls between the range F2 to F1, then the bandwidth is given as F2 minus 1 F1, say in hertz or kilohertz. So for the transmission, if let's say BW is the bandwidth of the channel, then these TV stations must also have same or similar bandwidths for the transmission of the message signal. Now since these are TV station, then the message signal will be mostly a video signal for all the TV stations. Now since they have got same bandwidth, then what will happen if all these channels want to transfer their signals at the receiver's end, then there will be mutual interference of the signals. Because they are falling in the similar frequency range, then there is bound to occur mutual interference. Or you can say constructive imposition, superposition of the waves. What will happen then? It will cause distortion, signal distortion at the receiver end. So these are the few limitations of the baseband transmission. We can summarize it here. Limitations of baseband transmission. The first one is signal attenuation over large distance . Second, cannot be transferred over radio or antenna, let's say. Third point. Mixing of signals. And as we saw here, since this signal gets a significant amount of distortion occurs during the baseband transmission. So we can add one more point here is the quality of signal reception is low. So because of these limitations of baseband transmission, we shift ourselves to another classification of transmission called the passband transmission. And in bracket, let us write the term modulation. What we are doing here is we are transferring or doing the transmission, transferring the signal transferring the message over the passband. Rather baseband. In the passband transmission, we don't transfer the baseband signal directly. We transfer the signal over the higher bandwidth. Transfer over higher range of frequencies. Called the passband. So let's see, with the help of block diagram, what we are doing here is, suppose this is our message signal, call it empty, Let's say this is our baseband signal. So the important thing we are doing here is we are trying to first modulate the signal, modulate the baseband signal with the help of, or you can say we modulate the baseband signal modulate the baseband signal over the high frequency carrier. Let's define a new term. We are modulating the baseband signal over the high frequency carrier wave. Now this carrier wave can be produced by a local oscillator. And let's say its frequency is f of c and the carrier wave will be sinusoidal. So first, what we do is first we modulate. We'll see what is the term modulation. First we modulate the message signal and then we transmit this signal with the help of transmitter over the wired or wireless channel. Let's say for the time being we are transferring wirelessly over the antenna. And then at the receiver's end, there will be a receiver. There will be at the receiver end, the received signal will be demodulated. It is the opposite function. In case of modulation, its opposite function is demodulation, and it is demodulated to get back the original signal, the baseband signal, which contains desired information. So roughly this is how the passband transmission is working. Now what do you mean by the term modulation? All the concept of passband transmission revolve around the concept of modulation. Let's see what's happening here. We have a modulator. Suppose we have a message signal MT. We multiply it with a carrier wave CT. Let's say the carrier wave is given by cos 2 pi f of c into t. And this is produced by some local oscillator. After multiplication, we obtain a modulated signal. Let's say it's called s of t, will be given by mt into c of t, which is mt into cos 2 pi fc of t. Now this signal is transmitted, being transmitted over the antenna. Now this is a some low pass signal, a signal of low frequency, and the carrier wave, let's write it here, this is a high frequency signal. Now if you observe this modulated signal s of t is given as mt into cos 2 pi fc of t. If you write the same thing in Euler notation, you can write this is the Euler form of the modulated signal. And also, since the message signal is getting modulated, then MT is also called modulating signal. Now, if we want to observe the same thing in frequency domain, if we apply Fourier transform here, can see if the signals applied multiplied with a complex exponential, then the signal gets shifted. See, if MT has a Fourier transform capital N of F, then the signal will get shifted by, if it is FC, then it will be F minus FC, and this will be M F plus FC by 2. You can observe here in the frequency domain that after multiplication by the local oscillator F of C, the signal is getting shifted. Shift in frequency is observed. Previously, previously we represented the message signal or the baseband signal as a low pass signal with cutoff frequency f of m fm. Now after multiplying with a local oscillator, the signal MF gets shifted by an amount FC. So if we try to plot this, we can write it here. So what is happening here, after multiplying with the local oscillator, the signal is getting shifted. So if we try to plot this, it will be the signal is shifted by the amount FC. This will be FC plus FM, and this will be FC minus FM. Similarly, if it is minus FC, so this will be minus FC. Plus FM, this will be minus FC, minus FM. And signal is attenuated by a factor of 1 by 2. This will be M F plus FC plus M F minus FC by 2, or you can write S of M. If our modulating signal is if this is s of t hence we can see now the transfer is not occurring in the baseband that is it is not occurring in the low pass region now the transfer of the signal is occurring at a higher frequency which is centered this frequency this pass band centered around fc the frequency of the local oscillator and that is why this is called passband transmission here we also consider the negative frequencies although negative frequencies do not exist but for the sake of mathematical interpretation we symmetrically consider the negative frequencies as well now such type of transmission is the passband transmission now you see here after the message signal or the baseband signal has been modulated now the signal can be easily transferred over the radio or via the antenna because this fc is in the range of let's say 100 megahertz and so on or greater than those value suppose if this is it is the frequency over which we are transferring the message signal so what is happening here is that suppose now we want to design the antenna then its length will be given by length of antenna will be given by suppose c upon 4 and 3 into 10 to the power 8 let's say we have considered a carrier frequency 300 megahertz it will be 4 into 10 to the power 8 you can see here we are left with 1/4 which is 0.25 meter which is very very small as compared to the baseband transmission so you can see how the limitations of the baseband transmission can be overcome using the passband transmission let us see again another example once again if you see there are numerous TV stations are there and they all are having passband transmission Previously, we had discussed about the baseband transmission, where there was mixing of signal was occurring due to mutual interference. Now suppose there are several TV stations are there, N stations are there. And let's say they have their own carrier frequency, let's say FC1, FC2, FC3 and so on, FCN. On the receiver end, let's say it's the television. Now what is happening here? Now what is the benefit of using passband transmission here? Suppose we will keep the bandwidth in such a way that we will apply a passband filter here. You say tuned passband filter here. Suppose we want to see the video program from TV station 1, then the frequency of this station is FC1. Then what will happen? This passband filter will tune to this frequency, and individually at the TV output we can watch the TV channel 1. Similarly, if you want to see the TV channels 2, then the band pass filter will tune the frequency to FC2 so that we can watch the programs available at TV channel 2. Similarly, there might be n number of channels. So just by the help of the passband tuning, we can allow multiple channels to pass through, multiple TV stations to pass through a signal channel. So this gives us the idea of multiplexing. We are transferring with the help of multiplexing, we can transfer multiple frequencies, or you can say TV stations, over a common channel. Now we will select the channel bandwidth in this case in such a way that this is our channel, let's say this is our channel bandwidth F2 to F1. So these frequencies will lie within the channel bandwidth FC1, FC2, FC3. So we can see that with the help of modulation, we can not only apply the concept of, or you can say, we can transfer this signal, the baseband signal, over very large distances using the antenna transmission, as well as we can allow multiplexing on the same channel, which we cannot do in case of baseband transmission, because in case of baseband transmission there will be mutual interference. So we can write here there is no mutual interference. Now finally we can define modulation modulation can be defined as the process of varying in signal let's call it as the carrier signal FC you can write the process of varying one of the parameters of any signal, call it as the carrier signal, linearly with the information bearing signal. Signal M of T. Now if this CT is a carrier wave, then let's say it is a sinusoidal wave, AC cos omega t, and let's say it has frequency omega c, and let's say it has a phase of phi c. Now you can see it has parameters, which are, what are its parameters? AC, omega c, and phi of c. Now if we vary the amplitude proportional to the message signal, then this is called amplitude modulation. Suppose we vary the frequency with respect to the linearity, with respect to the message signal, it is called frequency modulation. And similarly, if we vary the phase of the carrier with respect to message signal, and then this will be called phase modulation. And since we are varying it linearly, modulation, we can also call it as linear modulation. So in the next lecture, we will continue our discussion with the concepts of amplitude modulation. Thank you.